Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today I'm doing formulas solving for a particular variable. So when we did formulas before, we were substituting in, and now we want to solve for a particular variable. What does that mean? If I have A equals L times W, then we know that that's the area of a rectangle formula. And right now it's solved for A, because A is the variable that's by itself. So when we say solve for a particular variable, we might want to rearrange that. We could rearrange it so it is solved for L. How would we do that? Well, if we have A equals LW, and we don't want A to be by itself, we want L to be by itself. So what's the variable that needs to move? Well, it's W. How would you get rid of something that's being multiplied? You do the opposite operation, not the opposite sign. And then you say, well, I have two W's over here that cancel, and I have A over W, and I'm just going to leave that. So A over W equals L. Now that formula is solved for L. Okay, let's say I have P equals 12AB, and I want to solve that for B. What letter is it solved for right now? P. That's the variable that's by itself. So we want to get rid of what? We want to get rid of 12 and A. We can get rid of as many things as we want, but just being multiplied. In order to get rid of it over here, we divide. We have to do the same thing over here. So what happens is those things cancel out. And now we have B isolated. But over here, we have P over 12A. That's solving that for B. We could solve it for A by dividing by B instead. Okay, this is a little harder, and, well, not this one's all that hard, but it's a little more important, I would say, because we're going to use that when we get to linear equations in the next class or in higher algebra. You're going to do this because there's a particular form that we use for graphing. So in this case, it's saying solve for Y, but we're not multiplying, so we wouldn't divide by negative 3x here. Instead, we're adding, so we want to get rid of this term by adding its inverse, which is positive 3x, and then we're going to come over here and add positive 3x over there. Now, y is by itself, and when I write this, it's a good habit to write the variable term first, so that's how I'm going to write it. I think that you could write it either way, but you might as well start getting into using good habits now when you're first looking at things. All right, solve V equals LWH for H. You should try this one on your own. It's similar to something we've already done. This is the formula for the volume of a rectangular prism or something that has a length, a width, and a height. So we want to solve for H. Well, what do we want to get rid of then? We want to get rid of the L and the W. We don't really need those dots in between. LWH would mean the same thing, just like we had LW here, AB here. Sometimes you see them and sometimes you don't. The L's and the W's cancel, and you get V over LW. That's rearranging that, solving that for H. Final one, solve area equals 1/2 BH for B. This is a little harder because it's got a fraction in it. You know, there was a video I did that I couldn't remember the shape. It was crazy. There was a formula, this area equals 1/2 H big B plus little b, and I was totally stumped. It's a trapezoid. I could draw the picture. I could not think of the term for that, and actually I had to go look on the internet. It was totally gone from my memory banks, and I must have used that and taught that formula literally 1,000 times in my life. So that's an old age thing, I think. Okay, solve this for B. That means get B by itself. You have a couple of options here, but what should be obvious to you is that you need to get rid of the 1/2 and you need to get rid of the H. So I'm going to get rid of the 1/2 first. And I'm going to do that by multiplying by the reciprocal. That is 2 over 1. And that I'm going to have to do to the other side as well. Do you see that half of 2, 1/2 times 2, would just be 1? So those things would cancel each other out nicely, and I'd have BH. And over here I have 2a. I think this is the easiest way to go. Clear that fraction out. Now you want to solve for b. What letter is the problem? The problem is the h that's over here. We're going to divide both sides by the h. Those h's cancel. And I have 2a over h. All right. Fantastic. I will see you next time and have a